Hey y'all, welcome to another WordPress Wednesday. My name is Kori Ashton, and this is sponsored by Pressable. If you're looking for really great WordPress hosting and support, you've got to check them out. All right, you're here to find out about different types of form builders for your WordPress website. I'm going to show you five different kinds. Check it out. All right, y'all, the very first one I want to be bragging on is Contact Form 7, and it probably is the most popular contact form builder, one, because it's totally free, and because basically it has 5 million active installs. It's been around the longest, and it's there's really nothing else I can say about it, because when you start to look at it, there's not that much else you can brag about other than the fact that it's forever free. It is simple to install. It does come with one example form, and you can put it, of course, on unlimited websites because it's forever free. But it's not drag and drop. It is difficult to understand or learn because you're staring at a bunch of code and short code. Unfortunately, it doesn't save your entries whatsoever. It doesn't really have any sort of way to like easily add an anti-spam, even though it does say that there's an option for it. It's not super user-friendly. It's not very easy to customize at all. You can't change colors or font sizes or padding or anything naturally. If you know CSS, you would be able to do it. And there's really no conditional logic inside of it for sending notifications or redirecting to a different page. And if you're having any sort of hope of adding on anything extra, you're probably going to have to pay for it. Well, if that one bummed you out, you guys, let's look at Happy Forms, because I get really excited about this one. I've done a couple of extra videos on it, so if you're interested in those, I'll put the links to those in the description box below. Check those out, because this is definitely one of my favorites. It is forever free as well. Forever free, meaning there is no paid option. These authors have just been generous and given you every possible feature, bell or whistle. It is simple to install. It does have an example form. Guess what, you guys? It's drag and drop, no code necessary. And you actually see a live view going on right here that you can see. You can customize the colors easily. You can customize columns and actually put these in different columns. It does save your entries, which is phenomenal. It does have a basic redirect logic on the submit button. So if you want it to go to a different landing page that says thank you, you can do that. It does have anti-spam included, and of course it's on unlimited websites because this is forever free. Phenomenal product. If we're looking at the bad side of it though, I mean, I have to balance this out, right? There's not really any advanced conditional logic inside of here. So you can't set up conditional notifications. There's no payment add-on, so you can't really use this as a registration form if you need payments. You can't really use it as a simple shopping cart if you need payments. And currently, as of today, there's no email integration, but you can export the CSV file of all your entries. So there is a workaround there. Still phenomenal, phenomenal product. I'm super happy about Happy Forms. All right, let's check out Ninja Forms. A lot of you on my channel have asked me to take a look at this, so we're looking at it today. The basic version of this is free. They have over 1 million active installs going on, and it does have great reviews, so I've been impressed with that. So there's a free version, and then there's a premium version. So it is very simple to install since it's free. There are multiple examples of different forms that you can just click and go, start building. It is a drag and drop builder, which I love. It does save your entries. It does have basic conditional logic, which I was impressed with. And the anti-spam is already there, super easy to activate. It is, of course, unlimited websites on this basic version because it's free. And I was really impressed to see the really great documentation and support that it gives. If there's bad, this is not really a live view of what you're building. It's just a drag and drop interface. You do have to know CSS if you want to make changes to colors or fonts. And if you're looking to go anywhere of a premium feature like a payment gateway or email integration, you're definitely going to pay for it. Price range is starting anywhere between $29 and go all the way up to $499 for an agency license. And of course, you have to remember that you're paying that, you're renewing that license at least every year. Wow, that's a lot to think about. All right, let's look at gravity forms. If you follow my channel, you know I love gravity forms. It's absolutely one of my favorites, but it is paid option only. So that means there is no free version for you to tinker around with. You've got to be all in. But it is completely scalable and reliable. So I'm going to look at some of the good things. It is a drag and drop builder. It does, of course, save your entries. It probably has the most robust conditional logic I have ever seen inside of a form builder. I mean, every single field can hold conditional logic. It has a page option where you can break down the form into multiple pages or sections on your website. It does have an anti-spam included. It also has conversion tracking inside of it that tells you how many times the form has been viewed versus how many times it's been filled out, which is a really cool, very quick glance for your marketing, right? To understand if people are having form fear staring at your form and panicking. And of course, you get all of their premium features, all of the add-ons that come with each level that you purchase, right? So there are certain levels that you can purchase and get more and more and more robust add-ons. If I'm looking at the bad, you do have to upload it to install it. Since there's not a free version, you have to go over to their website, purchase a license, come back, install it, and then activate your key. It doesn't come with any example forms, just kind of out of the box. And you would have to know a little bit more of CSS if you're looking to really style it. There are premium add-ons that you can go out and purchase, third-party add-ons that you can purchase to style Gravity Forms. But kind of out of the box, if you're looking to quickly make changes to fonts or colors or the submit button, you're going to end up having to know a little bit of CSS. And then the prices fall in the range of $59 to $259 as of today. But that $259 is an unlimited license. You can put it on as many websites as you want. So if you're a developer or a small agency or enterprise level, it's completely worth the value there. And of course, per year licensing, same thing. You're going to have to re-up that license every single year. All right, I'm going to do a bonus. WP Forms, I have to talk about this one too because I'm really impressed with it. It is paid options only, but it comes from WP Beginner. So if you guys are familiar with my channel, you know I talk about these guys all the time. They have incredible tutorials. They've been around for a really long time creating great free content for you to learn WordPress. So you have to check out this really cool drag and drop form builder that they have. Now, again, it's paid only. There's no free option, but it does come with multiple example forms, drag and drop builder with a live view happening right there. It does save your entries. It does come with conditional logic. Anti-spam is also included, and there's quite a bit of premium features you get, again, with the different license levels that you'll purchase. If we're going to be looking at the bad, though, you do have to, again, go over and purchase the license, install it, and verify the key. You would have to do some CSS customizing if you're going to do some add-ons or some sort of a customizing the colors or fonts. The pricing gets to me a little bit. This is probably one of the more expensive ones, $79 to $429. And then again, you're going to have to renew that license each year. Hey y'all, I hope that helped you, and it's always interesting for me to hear about what type of forms you use on your WordPress website, so be sure to comment in the thread below. And if you're interested in trying out Pressable or any of these solutions I have, I'll have links to them all and even coupon codes in the description over in the written tutorial. Check them out. Let me know. Tweet to me. Let me know which ones you're using. I'd love to hear from you. Be sure to subscribe because every week I'm creating content just like this to help you improve your online marketing inside of the world of WordPress. I'll see you next time. Bye, y'all.